Okay, now I want to cover the different types of fill options. So we have a yellow star here. We know we can choose just plain colors, don't we? So we hit fill and we choose from the color wheel. Great. Underneath that, there's an option called opacity. And if I click and drag that down, I can see behind the star and through to that rectangle in the background. Okay, that's great. Also on opacity, this one's kind of hidden. It says switch to noise on that little circle there. So if I click on that and I drag this up, you can see I can start applying noise to the color I chose. Okay, so what else is there? Well, there's this color picker tool, and this one is extremely useful. So imagine you're making a design, and you've seen a color that you really love on a website, or maybe it's on a photo that you own that's on your desktop, or maybe it's within Affinity Designer. This is how it works, basically. You can click and keep your finger held down, and then you can go ahead and sample any color. So I could sample from this blue. You see the values change as I hover over them. Or I could drag it off Affinity onto a website or something. So for now though, I will just sample this blue color and I will let go. What has changed? Not a lot, except this little circle next to the color picker tool is blue. So if I click it, I can apply it to the star. Very handy. So let me just get rid of this rectangle in the background and we'll look at the other options. So we have swatches on the left-hand side there. If I click on that, basically these are color palettes that are pre-made. So there's colors. This is the one that comes with Affinity. But also if you click on it, you can see a bunch of Pantone colors if you're very particular. And there's lots of options there. You can create your own color palette as well. But you can see, look, I've made one there. There's one from Frankentoon. If you've seen him before, he sells things on Affinity Shop. But anyway, if you're beginning, just keep it on colors. And if you want, you can switch over to this and take one of these colors and apply them like that. Okay, so we've covered color as well, and now gradient. This option can produce some really cool results. So how it works is this. I've clicked on gradient. I can see there's this line where it goes from white to blue, but how do I actually apply it? Well, you apply it with the gradient tool. So if you look down here on the left-hand side there, it says gradient tool. The shortcut is G. So I'm going to click on that. Still nothing. Okay, so if I click from the top and down, and if you want to keep it straight, you just hold down shift, and I'll leave it about there. Now, if we go back up to that rectangle, I'll click on that. You can see it's slightly lighter on that side, slightly darker on that side. So on the left one, I'll just select it and I'll go down to color. Our color wheel is there again. I'll choose that kind of color there. And if I go to the second little color point, click on that, go back to color and choose a different color. That's a bit dark, so I'll bring that up a little bit. This is what you'd call a linear gradient because it's going from one color to another in a straight line. You can change the type here, elliptical, radial, conical. Play around with those as much as you want. And by the way, you can select these color points from either on the actual star. See, I can select that one or this one, or I can just go up here and select them from here. You can add extra points is what I wanted to say in the middle. So let's add one here. So if I double tap, you'll see one has appeared down here. I can move this around so it changes. I can change the color of this so it looks a lot different, so we can see what is the difference. Also, there's these little handles either side. So not only can I move this color point around, you can add as many as you want. You can also play around with these handles to squeeze in the color a little bit more here. So that's the basics of it. You can also select one side and make it completely transparent. So down here, I've selected the yellow one. I'll just grab this opacity slider, drag it down, and then this will be more transparent, as you can see by the checkerboard right there. And then you could just reverse gradient as well. And there's all those kind of options. And you can see right next to this little rectangle here, you can do similar things from there. They just give you lots of options to make your changes, rotate gradient, reverse gradient, etc. And I'll just add that if you ever click off of your shape and start editing something else, and you want to go back to your shape and play around with the gradient, then just select it, go over to the gradient tool or press G. The gradient line will appear and then you can start playing with it. And just whilst I'm here, I will show you elliptical. So I've just clicked on elliptical and you see, you can just drag this out and let me just get a little bit further in and you can drag it in like this. And also you can squash it. And whilst hovering over one of the color points, I can hold down control on the keyboard, click and squeeze it in like that. Moving on.